Okay, so we're here with Mike Diana, who is an amazing cartoonist who, if you haven't heard about his work already, then you're really going to enjoy this. And if you are already familiar with this stuff, then this is a rare opportunity to hear from the man himself. He's over here in the UK at the moment because Divas Publishing have released his book America. Well, it's actually two books in it.
It's a box set.
It's a box set, yeah. It's a giant thing. And there's also an exhibition of his work on at, what is it, the Divas Enclave?
1 and 5.
1 and 5. So that must mean there's a lot of stuff there.
Yeah, there's a lot of stuff. It's probably the most best collection of stuff, you know, wide variety of years, like paintings and artworks, the comics that I've had so far.
Mm-hmm. An overview.
Yeah, overview. Yeah. And the book is, you know, it's a nice thick book, so there's a lot of pages, and it's a...
Two nice thick books. One's color, and the other is mainly...
Essentially is that sort of the comic strips, and then the other is more single illustrations and short cartoons. To start off with, how did this exhibition come about?
Well, it had started years ago. Ivan had contacted me for the book they do.
Right.
Okay. And they had an issue with featuring my artwork and my comics in it.
Mm-hmm. This is a Czech publication.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, interview, and I'd sent them an image painting for the cover, and he had talked about doing a book, and it kind of just turned into growing into a bigger and bigger book as time went by. I kept sending him more images, and before I knew it, it was a big project, which I was happy about. And then one day he sent me an email and said, would I like to come here and have a show? And I said, yes, of course. And then it just all came together when it happened. I think he had a problem, he said, with one publisher. They looked at material and they didn't want to print it. And then he found this place that printed the book. And he said that they had started printing, they already made a contract up, and then they started taking a closer look at the material. And they said, well, we've already signed the contract, so we're going to go ahead and print it anyway. But I think they might have tried to back out too. And that's a problem that I've always had in the United States with my stuff, is that it's hard to find a printer that will just print whatever they want, I guess.
Sure. Transgressive material of this nature. Yeah. It's happened, and the book is here.
For people that haven't seen it and don't know about it, could you give us a bit of an idea of what it's like? Like, what kind of material is in there?
Well, The Boiled Angel kind of started out. Originally, I had a zine. Before that, it was called Angel Fuck. Mm-hmm. And I did 3 issues.
That's a Misfits reference.
I was a fan of the Misfits. I was living in Florida since I was 9 years old, but I feel like I was very oppressed, living in that religious kind of atmosphere. Mm-hmm. And that's partly what brought the Angel Fuck zine, why my work went in that direction, because I was being forced to go to church as a youth, and I felt like it was a way to rebel. I kind of started drawing, printing my own fanzines before I even knew what a fanzine was. And I started thinking about comics in the 70s. You know, you had the underground comics, the graphicness of it, and I figured when I was the 80s, they should be even more graphic. I kind of feel like I wanted to top the underground comics with my own comics, and what could I think of that was really gross, like infant mutilation, serial killers, and the priests molesting children. Going around Europe when I was 16, I was amazed to see all the crazy kind of comic magazines and comics that I could get at newsstands wherever I went. And I would take this back to America with me. A lot of this stuff we couldn't get there.
A completely different attitude to comics in Europe than in the States, and there's far less.
Even been here.
Absolutely. There's far less hysteria.
It's
way more accepted on mainland Europe. And in Japan as well. I mean, there's a lot, the similarities there. There's not so much anything goes just for the sake of it. It's just like far less, like I say, hysteria about a strong subject matter.
Yeah.
Thank you very much for chatting with us today.
Yeah, no problem.
Really appreciate it.
Had a good time.